You know, as much as The Flash loves to explore the general idea of time, with Barry zipping in and out of a bunch of different timelines, sometimes dealing with the consequences of messing around with time, most of the time not, it's crazy to think that we really haven't seen or heard much of anything about the show's first timeline, other than the fact that the original version of Eobard Thawne and the first future Barry are from it. I mean, sure, we may know some stuff about Thawne's personal history, considering the tidbits we've gotten here and there. I even did a whole video about his timeline, feel free to check it out. But there's still a ton of unanswered questions about the original version of Barry Allen and his overall relationship with Eobard Thawne, one of which being, just how in the hell did Thawne actually figure out who this guy really was? I know in the season 1 finale Fast Enough that Thawne mentioned he eventually learned Barry's true identity, leading to that stupid plan to kill his younger self to erase the Flash from history.
I learned your name. Barry. Finally, I knew how to defeat you once and for all, travel back in time, kill you as a child, wipe you from the face of the earth.
But how exactly he did it, we still have no idea. I mean, seriously, there's hundreds of millions of people in the United States alone, so what are the chances Eobard managed to narrow it down to a single person, even with time travel at his disposal? Well, actually pretty good as it turns out, especially when you consider what kind of information he really had to work with. I mean, come on, put yourself in Thawne's shoes for a minute and think about it. First off, The Flash is clearly most active in Central City, so chances are good he actually lives in the area somewhere and isn't just showing up from a nearby city or something. Even ignoring big clues like the museum, public appearances like those key to the city type events, things like that, both historical records and Eobard's own ventures back in time probably would have shown The Flash reacting a lot quicker to anything happening in Central City versus outside of it. So that already narrows things down to a range of just hundreds of thousands of people, assuming Jesse Quick was right about the numbers in the fourth season episode Enter Flash Time.
We can't run everyone outside the city. We're talking hundreds of thousands of people.
All the way up to a good few million, according to Caitlin in the fifth season episode The Death of Vibe. A bit better than before, but that's still a lot of people who, by the way, only represent a couple years worth of the Central City census. Eobard still has over 100 of those to sift through before he's even reached his birthday, so how do we narrow this down more? Well, what if Eobard decided to take a closer look at some of the Flash's equipment? I mean, somebody had to throw together that fancy suit and that overpriced Siri he carried around with him at some point, so those seem like good leads to me. But hold on a second. We know Cisco made Barry almost everything he's used in the show up till now, and thanks to Hartley Rathaway mentioning in this season's Pay the Piper episode that very few places in the world have the capability of developing a Flash-level suit.
And there's only 3 facilities in the state that could build a suit with that much bleeding-edge tech, but only one of them had someone brilliant enough to build it.
Thanks.
Harrison Wells.
You could argue that OG Barry had to have some help developing his superhero stuff, meaning he still could have worked with Team Flash to get everything he needed in the original timeline. But wouldn't this mean Eobard would end up following one of them around instead of Barry if he started looking at all the tech? Well, that's the thing. I'd argue that the OG Flash most likely didn't need to work with a Team Flash, or at least a version of the team that we would know. At most, he probably just pulled a Flashpoint Wally and had somebody else make him a suit, Cisco, Original Wells, somebody like that, but that's probably about it. I mean, for one thing, he created and used Gideon.
Why? Would you accept my commands?
Because you created me.
A fucking supercomputer with a wide range of uses, like detecting speed force levels, monitoring the time stream while traveling through time, detecting and analyzing energy signatures. She's like a mobile version of Team Flash, always there for if/when OG Barry needed a bit of in-the-field assistance. On top of that, we also know that OG Barry managed to reach a lot of milestones way faster than current Barry has, including becoming director of Central City CSI, developing Genie's computer programming skills, and turning himself into a veteran hero that even Eobard looked up to, or at the very least respected.
The you I know from the future, he's not this stupid.
Current Barry, meanwhile, has mostly relied on a team of people to handhold him through a lot of his Flash fights and investigations, as we've seen in a lot of the earlier seasons of the show. I mean, seriously, how many times has Barry seen something and just been like, "Ooh, let me run this thing or whatever to Star Labs and have somebody other than me analyze it," or, you know, whatever. Plus, his civilian life hasn't come anywhere close to the level his original self got to, which, again, you could argue is because he's had a lot of people to heavily rely on ever since he started running around in the Red Long Johns. Either way, though, Thawne is still narrowing down his list to whichever genius-level programmers and inventors lived in Central City around the same time as The Flash, so that's something at least. Although, considering how everybody in Central City seems to be a fucking genius these days, it probably doesn't do the job as well as you think. Still though, we've narrowed things down a lot, and thanks to the season 2 episode, The Reverse Flash Returns, we have a pretty good idea on how Eobard narrowed things down even further. In that episode, we see a time remnant,
timeline remnant,
of Eobard popping up in the then-present of 2016, mentioning that he was traveling through time just to figure out what time period the Flash is actually from.
Was the trip a success, Professor Thawne?
I believe it was. I finally figured out what time period the Flash is from.
Even assuming things worked out vaguely the same way for OG Eobard, meaning he ran back in time and saw Barry whizzing around in his supersuit at least once, then this would be huge for him. I mean, it would have narrowed down when he needed to search immensely, giving him a much more definite time frame he could look into in more detail after getting back home. Considering how the guy was able to dig up details on an ancestor apparently nobody really cared about, I think it's safe to say that he could find at least a few newspaper articles backing up his time travel findings, right? Speaking of examining records, after Eobard narrowed down the general time period the Flash originated from, he probably would have also noticed, if he hadn't already, that the Flash didn't really become active until after the particle accelerator explosion in 2020.
In the year 2020, you and your wife, Tess Morgan, successfully launched a particle accelerator that changed the course of history.
That, on top of Eobard's own research into giving himself speedster powers, would have helped him realize that another person would have had to have been struck by lightning, while being infused with dark matter, and being hit by a smattering of random chemicals all at the same time. Combine that with the genius computer programming, the central city base of operations, the most likely locations of those chemicals, and the time period the Flash would have been most active in, and it's very easy to assume that Eobard would have ended up with a reasonable list of suspects, which could easily be narrowed down with either more time traveling, or a Batman-like tracking of the Flash's running patterns, or a combination of the two, until he found out who Barry Allen really was.
That actually makes sense.
Damn, that's a lot of work just to go out of your way even more to screw with the one guy you really hate, right? I mean, I know there's more to their relationship and Eobard's eventual breakdown in the comics than they've talked about on the show yet, but who knows, maybe they'll cover it in a future season or something. But anyways guys, that's my take on how exactly Eobard originally discovered the identity of the Flash on... the Flash. If you guys agreed with anything I said in this video, or if you have your own thoughts you want to throw out there, then go ahead and let me know in the comments down below. Otherwise, I will see you all next time. Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this video, then go ahead and click that like button, and if you're new, maybe consider clicking that subscribe button too. I've also got links to my Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, Instagram, and Patreon in the description. You should probably check those out too. And if you want to see more of my content, then you can click the link to my last video. It's right there in the middle of your screen. All right, and I will see you all next time.